Hi everybody, this is Ravi from Precision Academy. Today I will talk about wildlife in Telangana, national parks and wildlife sanctuaries. What is there in store for you? I will let you know. Kasu Brahmananda Reddy National Park, 1994, just 1.43 square kilometers in Hyderabad. It's in Banjara Hills, Jubilee Hills area. So Mahavir Harina Vanasthali National Park, it's in Vanasthalipuram, just 14.59 square kilometers, it's in 1994. Mrugavani National Park, it's a deer park kind of, in 1994, 3.6 square kilometers, it's in Chilkur area. So these are, when compared to other national parks, these are very very tiny and also not much of biodiversity. I don't know, maybe just to create lung space, they earmarked some area and made them national parks. So generally national parks should have wide biodiversity, but that is not the case here in Telangana. And wildlife sanctuaries, yes, we have very big, very rich in wildlife. There are Nagarjuna Sagar Sri Sailam Wildlife Sanctuary, it's both in AP and Telangana, APTS. And then Eturu Nagaram, very beautiful, very scenic wildlife sanctuary. It's in 800 square kilometers. Kawal Wildlife Sanctuary, Kinnerasani Wildlife Sanctuary, Lanjamadugu Shivram Wildlife Sanctuary, Manjira Crocodile Wildlife Sanctuary, it's now having more than crocodiles, like lot of birds species are there. So Pakal Wildlife Sanctuary, so it's also very big, 860 square kilometers. So Eturu Nagaram, you can see scenic place here, like Godavari River flowing, waterfall, Eturu Nagaram, where Sammakka Sarakka festival also happens. Like flora, what kind of flora we see there? It is a southern tropical dry deciduous type, a teak, and its associates like Thiruman, Maddi, Bamboo, Maduka, Terminalia, Pterocarpus. So these are the flora. Basically it is tropical dry deciduous type. So when we come to the fauna, so I have colored the vulnerable species in this. So we have tigers, leopards are vulnerable, wolf, dholes, that is the wild dogs, golden jackals, sloth bears have also become vulnerable nowadays. So Chosinga, black buck, nilgai, sambar also has become vulnerable, spotted deer, chinkara, Indian giant squirrels, many kinds of birds we see here, reptiles. So we have mugger crocodile, which is vulnerable. So we have even pythons, cobras. So this is having rich biodiversity in the Eturu Nagaram Wildlife Sanctuary. Kawal Wildlife Sanctuary, this is also having a lot of biodiversity, like Kadam River flows here. So dry deciduous teak forest mixed with bamboos, Terminalia, Pterocarpus, Anogeseus, Cassius. So these are the, basically it is also dry deciduous forest. So fauna, when we come to fauna, it has like tigers, leopards, gars, chital, sambar, nilgai, barking duck, barking deer, so Chosinga, sloth bear, the ones in color are vulnerable. Kinnerasani Wildlife Sanctuary, it's again extremely scenic, a small island surrounded by the lake, river. So we picturesque Kinnerasani Lake with densely forested island in the middle. where is it? It is near Kottagudem. Four-horned antelopes, Indian gazelle, so Indian leopard, Indian bison, jackal, boar, sloth bear, crested porcupines, hare, jungle cat, ruddy mangoose, black buck, sambar deer, spotted deer, so rhesus, macaques, so macaque. So the ones in this color, leopard, bison, sloth bear, they're all vulnerable now. So Manjeera crocodile wildlife sanctuary, it was initially meant for crocodile breeding. Like in 1974, Magar crocodile had reached threshold of extinction in Telangana. So today there are about 400 to 600 crocodiles. There are some good news, like whenever hear from me on wildlife, don't think I will tell only bad news. Sometimes we see this kind of good news where we have now this effort materializing thanks to all those who participated in this. So good job done. Magar crocodiles, we now have so many. And also it's not just crocodile sanctuary, it's just a wildlife sanctuary with so many bird species there. Pakal, so this huge lake built by Kakatiyas in 1213. So what we find here, the fauna is sambar, nilgai, sloth bears, leopards, chausinga, four-horned antelopes, chital, chinkara, mountain gazelle, wild boar, black bucks. So mostly in Telangana we find almost everywhere these are the common fauna that we find. And then Nagarjuna Sagar Sri Sailam Wildlife Sanctuary, so this is very big wildlife sanctuary with very rich flora and fauna biodiversity. It's both in AP and Telangana. You see Bengal tigers here, how royal it is. So Indian leopards, sloth bear, dholes, pangolins are here, chital, sambar deer, and then black bucks, chintara, chausenga, lesser fauna also is there, like Magar crocodiles, not much in number, Indian pythons, Indian cobras, and then Bengal monitor, Indian star tortoise. So you can find star tortoise here. Peafowl, you can see here. So what are the endangered ones? So this is based on the claim of Telangana State Biodiversity Board. So I don't know which exact location we find this, but they say there are some spotted in Telangana. Wild dogs like dholes, I talked about them in some of the wildlife sanctuaries. And lesser felicans, I don't know how many are existing now. Nordman's green shank, and then Egyptian vulture. So these are the endangered species. So they are at the verge of leaving Telangana. So on the map of wildlife, map of Telangana, we need to protect them, save them. So before I conclude, I give you the state icons of Telangana. State bird is Palapitta. This is Palapitta, means Indian roller or blue jay. So beautiful, extremely beautiful bird. So I have also spotted sometimes in our neighborhood. State animal is jinka, which is deer. Jinka in Telugu is deer. State tree is jammichettu. That is Prosopis cinerari. So Pandavas have stored their weapons. That you might be remembering, Arjuna goes and brings them down in Uttara Grogahram. And then this is so sacred, especially in Dasara, they we give a leaf to the elders. We call it as Bangaru. So, and touch their feet. This is Jammichattu. So, the state flower is Thangedu, Thangedu Puvu. That is Tanner's Cassia. It's very symbolic because it's used in Batukamma festival. So, this is the these are the state icons of Telangana. Telangana has rich biodiversity. So, whenever you find time, try to visit and see the wildlife in the wilderness, not in the zoos. Thank you very much for joining. I suggest that you prepare like this for all the states. So go and see in the Wikipedia, all the wildlife sanctuaries have the list, and then search them in Google, and then go to that particular site, then see all the pictures and go from there. Have a big map in your house, having all these animals, keep knowing about them. One thing which is really important is the interest that you have. So you need to have that genuine interest to know more about wildlife. So not for the sake of exams or whatever. So if you have that kind of genuine interest, and then if you have interest to serve, if you participate as a volunteer, if you do some fundraising for protection activities, and then you will remember, and you have to do this for all the states and wildlife in India if you are an animal lover. Thank you very much for joining. Bye bye.